The book of Mark chapter 8.
Marcus hoofdstuk 8.
I am reading from verse 22 to 26.
Vanaf 22 tot 26.
Ja. 22 tot 26. Are you there to wait?
Heeft het geopend?
Are you there?
Bent u daar?
If you are there, say I'm there.
Als u daar bent, zeg ik ben daar.
Oh, just a few seconds. Say I'm there.
I'm there.
Say I'm already there.
I'm already there.
And you are still going. Alright. And he cometh to baptize her, and they bring a blind man unto him, and besought him to touch him. And he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes and put his hands on him, he asked him if he saw aught. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. After that, he put his hands again. Say again.
Again.
Oh, say again.
Again.
Upon his eyes and made him look up. And he was restored and saw every man clearly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he sent him away to his house, saying, neither go into the town, nor tell it to any man in the town. Amen.
Amen.
NLT. NLT. Can you go there fast? Or I should let somebody be there. NLT. New Living Translation, if you have it. Mark is a part.
Let's demonstrate.
I want about five people to come with me.
He says to the blind man, Yes.
I've heard along some people come. Those who are not feeling too shy come. About five of you. Pity. Oh, if you are coming, come. Yeah. So four of you are come soon. Let's say four of you, five, all of you are friends or you are neighbors. You know each other. How many are you? One, two, three, four. Five. Okay. So one had a problem with the eye. And so the rest you brought him to Jesus. I'm Jesus. So bring your friend. So who has a problem? Okay, she has a problem. So they brought her. Oh, sorry. Is the one. Okay. So you bring sorrow, and then when you brought him, you saw, oh Jesus, please heal our brother for us. Heal him. Yes. And Bible says Jesus did what?
Took the blind man by the hand.
And did what?
And laid him out of the village.
And so it means that Jesus took him out of from the people, from their presence, and took him away. So when I read that part, I stopped. Thank you very much. Yeah. So the friends were standing, and they were watching. And when you were asking Jesus, please heal him for us. Jesus, I am sure, diagnosed the issue of the guy and realized that this guy's issue is different. This guy's issue needs something different. The process for his miracle is different from the normal. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is this baby thing should be done before? Jesus noticed that in the realms of the spirit, this guy will surely receive healing. But it is not going to be like everyone. So Jesus held his hands and took him out of the midst of the people and took him somewhere else. Hallelujah. Jesus noticed that the process for his miracle, if he is to stand with the people, if he should still be with the people, because you know, sometimes when people come to Jesus for healing, you will quickly do it. Sometimes he will just touch you. Sometimes he will speak. If he asks you to do whatever, he will do it. But Jesus took his hands and moved him out of the midst of the people before he started attending to him. Because Jesus knew that he's going to do something out of the norm. Hallelujah. He's going to do something that if he should still stand with the people, he will start speaking into his ears. The moment Jesus is to do come, boom. Because the Bible says he speaks or smarts. In the moment Jesus is to do it, that is when you see people say, if it's me, I will do this. If it's me, I will do that. That is when you hear people telling the man some things. Even the friends who brought them, that is when they will show their clutch powers. That is when they will show that, yes, we brought you to Jesus. We brought you to church. You have to listen to what we say. Am I talking to someone? So Jesus took his hands. Can I tell you something? Sometimes there are some people you have to avoid them if you want your miracle to come fast. Sometimes you must seclude yourself, move away, move and concentrate on Jesus alone. Sometimes you have to keep this mouth shut. Sometimes you don't have to tell people some things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
what I'm trying to tell you.
Jesus moved him out.
Jesus had him.
I'm talking about the power of a second touch. Jesus moved him out of the midst of the people. Moved him out from town. Moved him out to where he would have time with him alone.
The
Bible says he spit on his eye. Because if he's to spit on the eye of the young man, and people are around, hey, you will get everybody defining what Jesus did to him. You will hear what people will say to the young man. You will hear what the definitions of people. Can I tell you something? Jesus is waiting for you, yes, for your attention.
And for your
Jesus is waiting for you to say, God, I want one on one with you. Because Jesus needed the young man alone. He needed to have time with the young man alone. So he moved him out of the people. He moved him out of the crowd. And after spitting on the eye, Bible says he laid his hands on the man. That means he prayed for him. And when he prayed for him, he asked him, how do you see? And the man said, I can't see clearly.
Ik kan niet goed zien.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Upon that drama, the man didn't see clearly.
Naast dat.
That gives me another reason.
Dat geeft mij nog
why een Jesus reason. Have to move him out of the people. Because that man will need a second touch. Say a second touch. Say a second touch. Say a second touch. A second touch. Jesus moved him out of the people because after the first touch, he wouldn't see clearly. And some of you, the Lord has touched you, but you are still not seeing clearly. But because you are still attached with people, you are listening to what the people are telling you, and because of that, you are not listening to Jesus. You have paid attention to some other people. And because of that, the voice of the Lord is not getting to you. Jesus moved him out of the midst of the people because the guy needs a second touch. He said, I'm not seeing clearly. And it's very dangerous not to see and see, how do you call it? Partially. Not to see and you see partially.
Om niet te zien en dan ziet u water.
Hallelujah. Because if you don't see clearly,
als u niet goed kunt
you are bound to make a lot of mistakes.
Zorg ervoor dat u veel fouten maakt.
That is when your level is not properly into the things of God.
Dat is wanneer u niet.
That is when you know God, you don't know him well. When you get to that level, everything is capable of moving you. You see, when you see and you don't see clearly, anybody you give attention to, the person can sway you off. If you see and you don't see clearly, anybody who will hold your hand to direct you, the person has the ability to determine the effect of your life.
Let your attention be on it. Om invloed te hebben op je leven.
If you see and you don't see clearly,
als u ziet en u ziet niet,
whoever you pay attention to,
wie u ook
the person determines what happens to you.
Die persoon besluit wat er met u gebeurt.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And most of us, as I talk now,
en de meeste van ons, als ik nu spreek,
we are not seeing clearly.
We zien niet goed.
And we need a second touch.
En we hebben een tweede aanraking nodig.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not seeing clearly.
We see it not good.
But we are still in the midst of the people.
Maar we zijn nog steeds in het
midden. And we are hearing their voices.
En we horen het.
And they are telling us things. And they are telling us past year and past day. And past year and past day. And because of that, you are not listening to what the Lord is saying. But I came today to prophesy and speak to someone. I came today to encourage someone. I came today to tell someone that God is calling on you. And when it's time, you stand before Him. You will stand before Him alone. And when it's time to give judgment, you will give account of whatever you do alone. Stop listening to people. Stop hearing people. Stop giving attention to people. And attend to the Lord. And give ear to the Lord. Give ear to Him. You will see clearly.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I just want to encourage somebody and let somebody know that TBCI. TBCI. We want to raise quality Christians.
Amen.
Let me say it again. We want to raise people who will fear God and be ready to serve God. If people are not ready to serve God and they are not ready to be focused on Christ, you wouldn't like us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am not talking about one or two misunderstandings here and there. Even married couples, they one or one survive misunderstand themselves.
Zelfs partners hebben soms een misverstand.
But I'm talking about people who are not ready to serve God, who are not ready to go with God. And I and my wife, we are ready to raise people who will focus on God and serve God and say, we will go with you. People who tomorrow, if they leave this place, we will still hear them holding on to God. We will still hear them lifting the banner of God high. We will still hear them carrying God's word. What you are seeing now,
what you new see,
is how do you call it? Meta. I want to use a big word like this. God is meta what? Metaphor. Change. Change. How is it? Metaphor. Metamorphosis. I want to say it properly. Hallelujah. Metamorphosizing. Amen. He's changing things. When God told us that we're going to take 10 years, I thought by the end of the year, we will get our place of worship. We will do this, we will do that. Because he says, take 10 years. But he's making me understand what he means by we take 10 years. Because I am very sure that if you are not ready for something or it's not prepared you for something, he will not give it to you. When God takes all of us, I listen, when God is to take all of us to a different place and we say it is for us, the way some of them will go and worry us, we will regret. So he has to do up. He's shaking and taking some out. We know if it's 3 people, then we have to get a small place. And therefore, I keep telling you this, we will continue to step forward.
Amen.
Look, if it's money, I will not let this woman stay here. If we lose our money, so today, people from other places are still calling us. Come. Who tell me she can't go to America? Who tell me Belgium here? If tomorrow we say we're going to Belgium, the number sure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So pastors, have you all, won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come? But we are listening to this man. Because he has to say, it is fine. Move. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm believing God that by the time God will say, it is time, move, by then God has raised another mama. God has raised another pastor. So that TBC Ahola will still be standing and it will be the headquarters of TBC Ahola. So tomorrow, when you move to London, you will see TBC Ahola there. And it will be you handling it. When you go to Palestine, TBC Ahola will be there. And it will be another person handling it. When you go to Amsterdam, TBC Ahola will be there. And it will be another person handling it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus took the hand of the blind man out of the midst of the people. Because he's going to speak in onto the eye of the man. And he knows what people can say. He knows how people can define it. He knows people will tell the man, Jesus don't respect you. Jesus don't regard you. The other day when he was healing this man, he only spoke and the man received his healing. How can I ask for you, he spat on your face before healing you? He spat on your face before placing his hands on you. Jesus knew what is in the heart of man, what man can say. So he had to move the man out of the people. He knows that this man, after a spat on his face, he will not see clearly. He will see partially. And when he is not seeing clearly, people will speak to him and he will refuse the second healing. And so Jesus has to push him out so that when he gets to that stage, nobody will talk to him. He will only focus on Jesus. I want to tell someone, don't look at anyone. Don't listen to anyone. You have to make time with Jesus alone.
Hallelujah.
Make time with him alone. Amen.
Amen.
And Bible says, when he got to that stage, and that stage is a critical stage.
It's a
critical stage. And every Christian.
And every Christian.
You get to that stage.
Become that.
You are not yourself properly.
As yourself.
Where you don't see things clearly.
As you
where you don't understand things very well. And I said, when you get to that stage, if you are not careful, the one you listen to determines your life, determines how you go about it. The one you pay attention to will tell you what to do. When he didn't see clearly, thank God he was still with Jesus. So he had another chance for Jesus to touch him. It is important that Jesus touch you again. Repetition is very important to the student. If I teach you and you are teaching and you say something once and you don't say it again, you don't help your class. Because it's not every student who hears once and stays. You have to repeat and repeat and repeat. That is why the Bible says that you don't have to forsake the assembly of the brethren. That is why it is important you come to church on Sunday, you come to church on Friday. That is why it's important you make time every day to pray. So that as you keep getting close to him, then you keep seeing clear.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is important he touches you again. And all I want us to do today is to tell him, God, touch me again. Touch me again. I am ready for you to touch me. Touch me again. Touch me again. Touch me again. Touch me again. Bible says in the book of Galatians 6:9. It says we should not be weary in well doing. That means that when you do good once, don't get tired.
Do it again.
And it's really, really important.
To say,
fellowship. When the more he touches you, the more you see clearly. The more he touches you, the more you receive from him. The more you come to him, the more you receive from him.
Amen.
Read verse 26 for me. I finish my message.
Jesus said to
Verse 26 says, Jesus did what? No, let's start from 25. Once more, Jesus put his hands on the man's what? Eyes. Then his eyes were what?
Open.
His sight was what?
Restored.
And he saw everything what?
Clearly.
Verse 26. Jesus did what?
Saying, don't even go into the village.
Tell somebody he's talking to you. Tell another person he's talking to you. Jesus told him, you see where I took you from?
Yeah.
If you are going back, if you go there, they will let you wallow again in what I took you out of.
So you wear a pig that were the source that I can find and how.
So go back home. Pass here. Don't pass here. Hallelujah. Will you agree with me that somebody can bring you to church, but the person wouldn't want you to go above him or her? You can be very close to someone who will love you too, but in the heart of the person.
In the heart of any person.
The person wants you to remain where you are.
The person that you blame for your best. Amen.
Are getting too close to leadership. Yeah. Leadership is having too much with you.
Leiderschap lacht te veel met you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus said.
Jesus said.
I'll touch you.
Kijk
me aan. Now you can see.
Nu kunt u zien.
But go home. Don't go to the village. Don't go where your friends are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know what? When you go back there, they will ask you, how did Jesus heal you? You will tell them,
you
spat on my face. And they will tell you, he spat on your face before he healed you. He has degraded you. Jesus don't respect you at all. And then all the breakthrough you have, it will go out of you. And you start thinking. Thinking. Today, I get to tell someone that even me, I'm married to this woman. But as apart from praying together for the church, I have a relationship with God. Personally, she has a relationship with God. Personally, I will stand before the judgment seat. Personally, she will stand before the judgment seat. Personally, nevertheless, I am not saying don't help anyone.
Right,
I am not saying don't be close to anyone. But what I am saying is that your relationship with Jesus must be an individual decision. You must decide to be with Jesus alone. Don't dance somebody's dance. Sometimes, some people can speak to you. And if you are not careful, you will put Jesus somewhere and follow another route. Be on your feet.